and Poland. And I'd like to convince you that Eastern Partnership is useful to Europe because it plays to our European advantage. Our main advantage in our relationships with our neighbors is that we are the largest economy on Earth, and we are also civilizationally attractive. The peoples on our periphery would like to become more like us. And Eastern Partnership is about helping them to integrate their economies, to raise their legal standards, the standards of protection of minorities. And therefore, it's a very effective instrument of our soft power. And it's working. Look at the developments just in the last days, literally. In Ukraine, we have a democratic election that nobody is surprised by, and we have we've had a democratic election in Moldova, and we hope that other countries will also respect the rules and the conditionality of having deeper relationships with us. I would also like to tell you that Michael Angel insisted, and he's right, that Eastern Partnership should also involve other countries. And I hope that under the Spanish presidency, we will involve countries like Russia, like Turkey, the United States, Japan want to be friends of the Eastern Partnership. Once we have good programs running, others want to join in, or, as in the case of Russia, take advantage of border management programs, of environmental protection, of programs to enhance the energy efficiency of the various economies. We will have the cooperation of ombudsmen, anti-corruption programs. All these things are there for the taking. It's of course a purely voluntary program that I think will help Europe to spread the kind of prosperity, predictability, stability that we need on both our southern and eastern peripheries. So I'm very glad that the Spanish presidency has treated this seriously, and I promise that under the Polish presidency next year, we will treat the Union for the Mediterranean equally seriously.
Thank you, Radek. A ver, preguntas.
Sí, yo quería preguntar al ministro Moratinos, pero también a los otros dos ministros. Hoy se celebra una reunión sobre Yemen en Londres y mañana una sobre Afganistán. En el caso concreto de Afganistán, ¿España va a hacer alguna aportación al fondo que se va a crear para la rehabilitación de los talibán? ¿Y qué tipo de ayuda se va a ofrecer al gobierno de Yemen, en el caso de Yemen? Y no sé si los otros dos ministros tienen algún comentario que hacer al respecto.
Bueno, justo cuando concluyamos con este acto, vamos a viajar a Londres, los tres ministros, y a participar en las dos conferencias en Yemen y la conferencia sobre Yemen y sobre Afganistán, y me va a permitir que tenga lugar la conferencia para anunciar los resultados y los compromisos. Son dos conferencias muy importantes, tanto la de Yemen por lo que supone de apoyo, lógicamente, a todas las reformas en materia de seguridad y garantías de que se hará todo lo necesario para garantizar la seguridad de toda la región, pero también, lógicamente, apoyo a las autoridades de Yemen para que sigan avanzando en todos sus esfuerzos de diálogo nacional y también de reforma económica y social que son necesarias. Y lógicamente, España va a contribuir a ese esfuerzo. Y en Afganistán tendremos, yo creo, lo más importante es el nueva fase de transición que se va a inaugurar tras la conferencia de Londres. Yo asistí a la anterior conferencia de Londres en 2005, una conferencia que se llamaba London Compact, ¿no? Es decir, cuál era el plan que que la comunidad internacional se planteaba para el inicio de la reconstrucción y estabilización de Afganistán. Ahora estamos en un proceso de afganización y de ayudar a las nuevas autoridades afganas a reencontrar la reintegración, la reconciliación y también la formación de todo su ejército y sus fuerzas armadas. Y España ya está participando en todos los sectores, tanto militares como civiles, de cooperación, y me va a permitir que los anuncios y los compromisos los haga desde Londres cuando hagamos balance de los resultados de la conferencia.
Well, I think the McChrystal strategy has it right, namely that we need to keep up the pressure on the radicals on both sides of the border, in Pakistan and in Afghanistan. We need to put greater emphasis on the protection of the Afghan people rather than our own forces. We need to double the size of the Afghan National Army and the Afghan police. And we need to complement the military surge with the developmental surge and with the political process. And only when all these things fall into place do we have a chance of success. And I define success as the ability to withdraw from Afghanistan, to start withdrawing in about 2 years while leaving the country under the control of a legitimate government. And I hope that London will achieve the developmental surge and the political process part of the strategy. Poland is contributing its bit. We've declared we would increase our presence from 2,000 troops to 2,600 in the province that we are responsible for in Ghazni by April, with 400 additional troops on standby, ready to be used, for example, to help with policing the elections. But I think we all want we all know that we don't want to be in Afghanistan for any longer than is necessary. So I think the aim of working to our own calendar, namely telling the Afghan government, frankly, that in 2 years' time they will start to be on their own, is, I think, a good plan. Thanks.
If I may add to what was just said, for the as far as the Yemeni conference is involved, the Czech Republic won't be represented at this conference, but as the Ministers of Foreign Affairs of the EU, we adopted on Monday the conclusion speaking about the comprehensive approach to the security and the integrity of the Yemeni, and for the political dialogue between the northern part and those tribals and the government, and supporting the Yemeni government in fighting against the terrorists and Al-Qaeda. So as far as the Afghanistan and the Czech Republic, so as Radek already said, there are two pillars of the new strategy, which is the military one and the civilian one. And just in the last 2 days in Prague, we had the conference, international conference on provincial reconstruction teams, organized together with the Americans, and because of the fact that the Czech Republic has in province of Logar the PRT. And this is a tool, this is an instrument through which we are contributing to the stabilization, to the good governance, to building schools, hospitals, even the mosques for the people, in line what is important for the local governments. So we have both aims in our mind, so to support, to increase the support, not only the financial, for the local governments through our PRTs, also hopefully from the EU funds. And the second one is that the Czech Republic intends to increase the number of its troops. We have already increased in the ISAF operation by 40%, but the government will on Monday discuss some additional contributions to our presence in Afghanistan, I mean military presence.